Our applicant tonight is Anne, a 75-year-old lady from North London. She's travelling on the bus, as she does most days, but today we've secretly taken control of the vehicle. We've wired our recorders into the onboard security cameras, and all of the passengers apart from Anne are actors. The driver has been told to leave his normal route and drive to a secluded spot where we have more hidden cameras waiting.
I'll have a look at her after a while. I won't stay.
Stay where you are.
Very pleased to meet
you.
You've applied to come on the show, and we'd love to use you.
Really?
We'd love to use you on the show.
You're picking me, are you?
I'm picking you right now.
Oh,
God,
now my tummy goes.
Let me explain how the show works, all right? Okay. So listen very carefully. What happens to you on the show depends on your choice of one of these two cards here, all right? Mm-hmm. Now, you'll see one of them says trick mm-hmm. on it, and one of them says treat.
Right.
Okay? Now, if you pick the card that says treat, and I'll put them there where you can see them. If you pick the card that says treat, then what happens to you will be something lovely and something you'll really enjoy.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
But if you pick the one that says trick, then it won't be. It'll be something a bit horrible. Do you want to play it?
Yes, please.
You do? Excellent. Pleased to hear it. So first of all, I need to get you to sign this, which is your contract. That just allows us to do anything we like with you.
You can... I'm a bit shaky, so
you
have to...
That's all right, no, you shake away. That's right, signed by contributor, that's you just there. Thank you very much indeed, that's lovely. Thank you, Anne.
Thank you. Oh, God, what have I done?
Okay, let's see what you pick. So, you're going to choose one of these two,
mm-hmm.
and you're going to choose it just by putting your finger on it just for a second. Excellent. Okay. Well, I don't want you to see what you've picked.
Okay.
So if you face the other way and close your eyes for a second, I'm going to show the camera. But I'm not going to let you see for now.
Okay.
Thank you, Anne. You can look back now. So that's all for now, and you'll hear from us in the next couple of weeks.
Really?
Yes.
Thank you.
See you soon.
We'll learn more about Anne's treat later on.
You are. I really thought I was being kidnapped, to be honest.
It's been 2 weeks since I met Anne on the bus. I've now asked her to meet me at Victoria House in central London.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Nice
Mr.
to
Brown.
See you again, thank you.
Thank you.
Don't call me Mr. Brown.
Oh,
sir, it's fine.
Anne still has no idea of what I have planned for the next week.
You play a little bit of cards, is that right?
Yes, not anything special. I play brag, rummy, a pontoon.
Okay. Just with friends or
with just my husband and his friend.
Well, a week from now, we're going to enter you in a poker game with some world-class poker players.
Oh, no.
With the idea that you're going to win quite a lot of money from them. So over the course of the next... week.
I don't play
poker. I know you don't play poker. but you see, if you did play poker, you'd have a way of playing which would get in the way. I'm going to teach you my way of playing.
That's a royal flush.
I teach her the rules of the poker game she'll have to play to world standard next week, namely Texas Hold'em. It's important she doesn't become too stuck on learning the rules at this stage, as they'll get in the way of the psychological techniques I want her to pick up on.
Essentially the structure of the game, sort of fairly simple. The fun starts in terms of how you bet.
Mm-hmm. Players obviously try and keep their cards a secret, so I'm going to teach Anne some skills at telling what card a person is holding.
Ace, king, queen, jack...
First, I demonstrate by trying to tell her what card she's thinking of. The ability to read physical cues accurately will be invaluable when she's faced with the professional players.
Might give that away, so I'd say it's probably the Jack of Spades.
Yes.
Is that it?
Yes.
Excellent, okay. So...
God.
Ace.
Using a friend who's a poker enthusiast to help us out, I ask Anne to try and guess the card he's thinking of just by watching and listening to him.
I'm going to go for spades.
I'm going to go for spades. I'm going to go for diamonds. I think it's king of diamonds. Was that it? Was that it? Okay.
I'm never going
to
do this.
Oh, yes, you are. By the end of this, you'll be able to do this. You better do this like that.
I show her how to create a certain state of mind, one in which she has the confidence to totally believe that she's capable of winning.
Your responsiveness and your receptivity opening up.
Even though she may not understand this process, it is important that she trusts her instincts, in this case, regarding the first card that comes to mind. I haul in our makeup artist and we start again.
9, 10.
Did anything at all occur to you during that order?
Well, she counted 9.
Okay, and the suit?
Hearts.
Hearts. Anywhere close?
8 of diamonds.
8 of diamonds. Okay. Close your eyes for me. In your mind, you're going to feel that confidence and that openness.
I have Anne refocus and get her to try the exercise again using her heightened receptivity.
Jack, queen, king.
You got one?
Hmm.
What was the card?
5 of diamonds.
5 of diamonds. That's
oh,
really
no.
good.
What have you done to my brain?
Great, okay, well, it'd be lovely if you don't mind a bit of homework just to have a look
yep,
at that and
I
just get your husband
I
to test you.
Okay. Right. I must admit, I'm a little bit scared because I'm not very good with my memory sometimes. I suppose it's my age, I don't know. But Derren is absolutely marvellous, isn't he? I don't know how he gets to put things in your mind, but he does.
Throughout the week, Anne has been improving her skills by playing a few social games of poker.
I'm folding. 2 pairs.
Oh, well done.
I'm all right, but I'm still a little bit wary of the big one when it comes to when I'm playing professional poker players.
They must recognise her straight away. She can't play, sure.
It's all very well playing at home, but it will be a much tougher challenge against a group of world-class professionals. 2 days later, Anne joins me for our last session together before her big day.
When people talk about keeping a poker face, the idea is they're trying not to give it
up.
Reading a bluff is one of the hardest but most fundamental parts of poker.
Things that they will do.
There are numerous signs that give away information about a player's hand and intentions.
They're going to try and appear weak. If they've got a weak hand, they're going to try and appear strong.
I have her revisit her state of heightened receptivity.
And your ability to read the unconscious signals that people are giving off. Amplifiers.
It's time now to build on her increased intuitive skills with some more exercises.
You're trying to get all the high cards.
A card will be identified as high, that's an 8 up to an ace, or low, and I get Anne to use her newly amplified intuition to sense a bluff as to whether the card is high or low.
This is a high card.
Low.
The cards are then placed face down into 2 separate piles according to her predictions.
This is a high card.
To get her used to reading a range of male faces rather than just mine, I have another card enthusiast try to bluff her as well.
I'll have that one, I believe you.
Okay, let's stop there. So 8 and above, you just spread them out on the table.
She turns over the piles she believes to be high cards, and she scores pretty much 100%.
And these are all low? That's really good. That's very, very good.
Despite being confident that Anne has absorbed enough of my skills to compete well in the tournament, I cannot influence the random dealing of cards. So if she gets dealt bad cards on the day, she may